Dear students, I am going to give a PowerPoint presentations of structural isomerism of organic chemistry. So first you need to know what you mean by isomers and what do you mean by isomerism. Isomers are the compounds having same molecular formula but different in arrangement of atoms or groups around the compound. And the phenomenon is known as isomerism. The isomerism of organic compounds is divided into two types, structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism also called as constitutional isomerisms. So next, structural, what do you mean structural isomerism? Structural isomerism or constitutional isomerism arises due to the same molecular formula but arrangement in different orders. So it is further subdivided into these following types: chain isomerism, positional isomerism, functional isomerism, metamerism and tautomerism. So first come to the chain isomerism. Chain isomerism means different in arrangement of atoms or groups in a linear or branched chains. Chain molecules, chain isomers have same molecular formula but different types of chain, that is linear and branched chains. Always remind that the branched chain have lower BP than that of the counterpart, that means linear one, because the linear one having more surface area in contrast. Branch means it means squished. So the surface area is less, so the intermolecular force of attraction is less, so BP is lower. So given, I'm giving an example of chain isomerism, that is this, see, this is the linear structure of butane and this is the branch structure of butane, that is known as isobutane or 2-methylbutane. Both is having molecular formula same, that is C4H12. Then next come to the positional isomerism. Positional isomerism generally arises due to the different position of the double bond, functional group, side chain, triple bond, etc. Just see the example of but-1-ene, that means one, in case one butene, the double bond is at one position, and in this case the double bond has two position, that means two butene. Likewise we can say another example is orthoxylene, metaxylene and paraxylene. In case of orthoxylene and metaxylene, paraxylene, xylene means benzene containing two methyl groups, that is known as xylene. So ortho, meta and para are positional isomers. Next come to the functional isomer. Functional isomerism means the molecular formula remains same though different in functional group in the structure. So see, this is an example of ethyl alcohol. In this case the OH group, functional isomerism is alcohol, and in this case the functional isomerism ether. Both is having different functional group but the molecular formula remains same, that is C2H6O. Similarly another example, that is acetaldehyde. In this case the aldehyde CHO is functional group, but in this case this is the functional group of ketone, and both these having same molecular formula, that is C3H6O. Then next come to the metamerism. Metamerism means it generally arises due to the unequal distribution of alkyl group or different alkyl group attached to the same functional group. See an example, that is this is the functional group of ether, it is also the functional group of ether, but in this case in the left side there is two carbon alkyl group, that is ethyl, and the right side there is two carbon alkyl, that is ethyl. But in this case, see, this is methyl and this is propyl, and in total there are four carbons. It is divided into 2, 2, and in this case this is divided into 1 plus 3. So unequal distribution of alkyl group in the same functional group, that is known as ether, that is known as metamerism. Also metamerism can be possible in amine also. See, this is the amine on alkyl group, 2 carbon ethyl group, and in this case ethyl group, in this case methyl, and in this case propyl. So next come to tautomerism. Tautomerism, this exists in dynamic equilibrium with two compounds with same molecular formula. So it can be also known as desmotropism, cryptotropism, prototropy and allelotropism. The first come to the ketoenol tautomerism. Ketoenol tautomerism, that means the dynamic equilibrium exists between keto form and enol form, and it must contain a alpha hydrogen. So next, in this case the carbonyl group converted to enol form due to the transfer of one alpha hydrogen, to oxygen atom. I am giving an example in the next slide. See, this is, see this is the keto form, this is the ketone group, and this was the enol form. The hydrogen from the methyl group migrated to the oxygen to form OH group, and this is known as enol form because it contains ENE and alcohol. So ENE minus E plus OL, that is enol form. So this one is keto and enol form. We can say another example that is known as phenol, and this is the ketone. So this one, see, the enol form is more stable than that of the keto form because in this case resonance stabilize the aromatic ring. In this case no resonance structure is available, so obviously in this case the enol form is more stable than that of the keto form. And second tautomerism known as nitro acid tautomerism, and generally it is seen in the nitro form of the compound. See, in this case this is nitromethane. In this case the hydrogen, the alpha hydrogen, suppose this is the functional group, it must be the alpha hydrogen, it must contain an alpha hydrogen. The alpha hydrogen migrates to the ketone group so that it becomes CH2 and this oxygen becomes OH. It is known nitro acid tautomerism form. Thank you.